Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. We did have another video cross 5,000 likes over the weekend. Happy Monday, everybody out there. We are now only 1 week away of, well, equivalent like streak goal counters down below. 2 of 3 out of 210. Let's make it happen and get it rocking and rolling. Hope everyone had a great start to your brand new week here at the Mosh Pit. And speaking of brand new, we got a brand new meme of the day. Brought to you by Matt. Title of the thread was a banger meme for a banger run. An almost hour-long Svicta video. Svicta playing Jacob and Hee-Haw. Svicta going alt path on his first lap. Svicta finding Blind Jesse. Oh, the Vince meme. Thank you very much, Matt, and all 182 of you who upvoted that one at the time of this recording. Let's hop on into today's Eden Run, get rocking and rolling. We've had some rough runs over the weekend. Talk about that in a moment. C-Day's going to be Mike Quebec 8 Kilo, Alpha Kilo 1. Or not Kilo, sorry. Try that again. Mike Quebec, 8 Kilo, Alpha Quebec, 1 Tango. There we go. And we also start out with Sackhead here, which is going to give us 3 bombs to start with, which is kind of nice, and also got Undefined. So, yeah, 4.4 damage, not too bad. Our tears rate is... I don't know what to say. We were going to get hit. I didn't want to skip the entire... I didn't want to skip the entire floor, but Tiny Planet and Dirty Mind, I think we can do better. Yeah, okay, fine. I'm not a big fan of the finger, but I'll take it. And I guess we'll just head on down to the next floor. Yeah. So as I was saying at the start of this run, we've been having some pretty rough runs on stream lately. Had a horrible, just god-awful run on Saturday before the Pokemon break. And it was rough, man. Like, it was one of the worst runs. I know, like, it's easy to exaggerate that, but seriously, it was one of the worst runs I've ever seen in all of Isaac. So I'm hoping that today is not going to follow that. But what this run does have in common with that run is the fact that we have horrible movement speed and terrible tiers. And again, the most dangerous situation you can find yourself in Isaac is going to be low tiers rate. If you find yourself with like less than like 2 tiers per second and you don't have a crazy amount of damage or an insane like insane tier effect, you're going to be in a lot of trouble. So obviously it was unintended for us to actually get to the I Am Air room upon using Undefined. That doesn't normally happen, but of course it will happen whenever you're not expecting it to or wanting it to. And yeah, that's a pretty not good item right there. Boil Baby. You know, Boil Baby does have a lot of DPS, but the problem with Boil Baby is that it will fire off constantly, and also it makes a visual doo-doo of sprites and shots on the screen that makes it very difficult to see things that are going on. But it does do a lot of damage, I will say that. So you might be noticing here that the enemies are flashing red, and you're like, well, how the heck are you hitting those? Well, that's what the finger does. And again, I'm not a huge fan of the finger anymore because it does have a tendency to blow up stuff that's right next to you. So you have to be very, very careful whenever you enter into a room and there's like a barrel or something right next to the door. Of course, if you've never seen the room before, you have no idea that it's there, then yeah, it's going to be a little bit difficult to do that. But either way, you still have to be cautious. However, the benefits of the finger are the fact that it does have piercing and spectral tiers and unlimited range. So, you know, if you do happen to find yourself having a bad situation with tiers, you can just point the finger at something and they will eventually die. I don't think a Seagram's here. We can get that nickel if we really wanted to. Super Seagram's probably there. Yeah. Let's go fight the boss first. Obviously, missing out on the first floor boss fight is going to be kind of crappy. I don't mind getting taken to the I Am Air room, just like we were going to get hit, and I didn't want to get hit, and I figured that we'll just get taken straight to the secret room. Yeah, this is just kind of showing you how horrible our movement speed is right now. 0.87 is a base movement speed is just god awful. So take down Fruity Plum here after getting his guaranteed shot on us. We do get a tears up in the form of eye drops. And we can't take any of that. All right. Yeah. Take us to the secret room. That's pretty much where I thought it would be. Super secret room is where I think it is, though. And, whew, those improved shops, man. Let me tell you something, brother. They are something. Now, I do actually want to kind of go into this boss trap room. Because, again, we're trying to make up for the fact that we weren't able to get into the first floor item room, nor the first floor shop or boss room. So we got to try to get something. Hangman. Nice shot. Try to get to Undefined. Try to get another full charge on Undefined. If we can do that, we can damage ourselves for half of a heart somewhere, I'm sure. And get out of the boss trap room. There we go. So still 6 cents. Not a crazy amount of... we spent a lot of money in there. I could use this hangman card, actually, to get those coins. We still need to somehow damage ourselves for half of a heart. There we go. So you might be wondering, how come I'm doing that? Again, it's because we can only get in here if we only... Actually worked out for us. Not only did we get an IMR room, but experimental treatment actually gave us an all stats up for once. Wow. Sorry about that. I muted my microphone to blow my nose. So, experimental treatment actually working out once, taking away from our shot speed and then giving us an all stats up for once. And then on top of that, we also got taken directly to the IMR room, which gave us a whole bunch of soul hearts. So that worked out probably more perfectly than I ever would have possibly ever could have imagined ever. I will take this because it's normally a net positive, and it is. Red stew, for 15 cents. I think we can do better. This is a situation where I don't believe that the red stew is going to help us that much. It is gonna boost our damage by a whole lot, of course. But we're probably not going to get more than one floor of profit off of that. I think we're better off holding on to this 15 cents and waiting for like a map upgrade or humbling bundle or something like that. There's a tinted rock here. Now you're gonna see me take advantage of the spectral properties of the finger. Yep, just making things easy for us. It gives us a tears up. I gotta take the tears up. It's not a super great tears up, but it's better than what we normally would probably be able to find inside of an item room at this stage. Lost Soul Buddy. Lost Soul Buddy, if he stays alive, he can give you a benefit. We're not going to Beast, at least not right now anyway. You never know, though. We might do an impromptu Beast Week run or something. I was talking about it on stream the other day about how popular All Beast Week was. People loved it. I enjoyed it. It was probably our most successful and most popular themed week ever that we've ever done. So definitely expect more out of that. I mean, the next one we've got coming is All Items Taken Week, including All Pills, which is just going to be bonkers. It's the one that people have been waiting for, where we have to take every single item. Doubling up on the damage here on Bambino. With the finger and just our tears. Should give us a movement speed upgrade, I believe. And we get Empty Vesida. And also get Duality if we want it. I'm going to say no to Duality. Well. Nah. Yeah. Wow, two luck upgrades there and two dimes as well. So Empty Vessel is going to give us movement, or not movement speed, but flying, as well as give us that damage shield that we all know and love. So we just need damage now, and really what I'm hoping for is if we can get like a pentagram or even like Maw of the Void or something like that, even though it's not a damage upgrade, anything that causes us to deal more damage is fine, whether it be through our base value or our tier effect. I'm totally A-okay with that. Just need to clear three more. We will have a full charge at the end of the at the end of that mob trap room. I'll go back into the curse room real quick just to see what else we can get. I mean, we gained half of a soul heart. It's fine. We do have this full charge here. I'm actually just going to buy the full charge, and then that way we don't have to do the mob trap room, because we can just use the undefined full charge to get out of there. And then hopefully we'll go 3 for 3 on the I Am Air rooms. That would be pretty impressive. Nope. It was a good try, though. We'll head on down. Wait a second. Okay. We'll head on down. All right. Two hearts and judgment. Wouldn't mind just a regular old judgment here. If we get an HP upgrade, I'll probably take it at the end of the level just because I don't want to ruin our empty vessel. Although I guess we're early enough to where it doesn't really matter, but you know, we'll come back for it. Just in case. You never know if that's going to actually save us the damage. Empty Vessel only activates, which means that we would lose our flying, by the way. It only activates if you have no red hearts. And that includes the flying and the damage shield, of course. So you really do need more movement speed. Hot bombs gives us 5 more bombs, and of course every bomb that we leave is going to lay a red candle shot on the ground for us to deal extra damage to our enemies. It's pretty useful. You know, it's good for bosses, especially ones that kind of bounce around all over the place, like Husk or Old Dookie, or, you know, Rag Mega, stuff like that. So really would love to get a little bit more movement speed. I don't keep talking about it, but it is pretty important. Hangman is going to give us flight. Doesn't really matter for us because, you know, we've got flying. But we need to go back and go get that HP upgrade before we go fight the boss, which is, of course, not in any of the directions that we've gone. You can tell by the map. So there's our damage shield there given to us by Empty Vessel. And I'm just going to kind of enjoy the perks a little bit. Latch key is going to give us a luck upgrade, as well as 2 keys and a soul heart. As we still continue to try to look for this boss room, which is not over here. All right. So there's the entire Flooded Caves 2 map for anyone who is playing along at home, which I know you're not. We don't really have a lot of people who play along with the runs lately. I will use 2 keys just to see what's in here. Yeah, I'm glad I did. Big tiers upgrade for the screw. Big time plays. There we go. We finally find the shop as well. And it's a Greek fight. get a Steam sale here, which is fun. I do get to go get my tooth looked at finally tomorrow at the dentist. And most likely, I've had plenty of them before now at this point. I know that I'm probably going to need another root canal. And that's just, that's just no big deal anymore. This would be like my fourth or fifth root canal. I don't know what's going on, man. It's like my teeth are just like, yeah, you know, we used to be super strong and really, really good. And now it's just like, ugh. We're made out of like Swiss cheese. Swiss teeth. I was going to try to say like Swiss cheese and teeth at the same time, but didn't really work out too well. Going to be Black Champion Forsaken. And it likes to spawn a bunch of adds. It doesn't do the Twirly Bird Brimstone shot. Let's see if we can get the hot bomb down there. We did, but unfortunately he went ethereal before we could actually hit him. There we go. Get a range upgrade, hooray. Guppy's Tail along with Vengeful Spirit. We'll take the Guppy's Tail. I'm not gonna take Vengeful Spirit. 3 hosts, okay. Alright, I guess I will take the Bone Heart. We could have used it to get rid of Vengeful Spirit, but whatever. And we get Keeper's Sack from the undefined error room. Wow. Look at that. Undefined. Get a range. Oh, we get a tiers upgrade too and a shot speed upgrade here with the torn photo. Wow. Holy smokes. Okay then. Well, things has gotten a lot more interesting. That is impressive. I've never seen Undefined be so successful in all my years of using the item. And I mean, Undefined is only half the story, too. We got to give a special shout out to the I Am Error Rooms for just delivering. Now, the problem with this is that our tiers rate is great now, of course. Our tiers rate is really, really nice. But we're not getting any associated damage upgrades, so we really need Keeper Sack to kind of pick up the slack here and help us out. We've got all the bits and pieces down for a solid run. Now all we need is just the damage. Already found the secret room, so we already know it's not there. Remember, we have a bone heart, so we need to get rid of that in order for us to get back our flying. Get a hermit car, reverse hermit car, which is not really going to be that useful. More keys than we can shake a stick at. I gotta say, Sackhead has also been a pretty good acquisition for us, even though we kind of started with it. Well, we're going to take everything here just because we need to... We need to get as much damage as possible. Look at that. The damage is starting to pile up already. Fantastic. You find that item room. We could forego it and go straight to the boss. We also need to be on the lookout for planetariums as well, considering that we did skip that first floor entirely. Although the item room on the first floor is technically open, so I don't know if that helps contribute towards the... Planetarium or not? Planetarium chances? I think it does, but I'm not 100% on that. There's a lot of those instances with me and Isaac. I'm not 100% on a lot of things, but I try to be as much as possible. Piggy bank. It's just going to help us with more money that we can use for Keeper Sack. If we end up doing a victory lap, which I'm 50-50 on right now, to be honest, because, like, our damage is not super great, but also my tooth is really bothering me. And I hate to use that as an excuse, but, like, Yeah, talking has been, like, I've been cutting the streams a lot shorter, too, as some people have been pointing out, just because of it. So hopefully I'll at least get something to help out with the pain on Tuesday. I hope. We'll see how we're feeling in about like 20 minutes when we have to make the decision. Fortunately for Loki, I can still hit him there. We get another Tears upgrade, an HP upgrade. And we get our second Guppy item in the form of Guppy's Collar. And we did not get a I Am Air Room that time around. All right, so we've taken a little bit of a hit on our time, but we need to make boss rush. We got about 2 minutes to go straight to boss rush. We're gonna have to use a lot of bombs here. Thankfully, we do have a lot of bombs, so we can manage it. We don't even have to worry about finding the Tinted Skull because we have this moon card for us. Definitely come back to the shop. It's being stuck by the ladder here. About maybe a minute to get there. We did get there, good. Chose the wrong door to guess, that's okay. Away our bone heart. Well, it took away our filled bone heart, but we're still technically there. I am for a empty vessel. Oh man, lead pencil or the cancer item. I'm gonna go for the lead pencil just because of our fire rate being so good. And we've got enough keys to really play this key beggar here, I think. Where Sackhead is also kind of influencing that, because we're just gonna get every chest that we get in here and we open is going to just give us more and more stuff, thanks to all the sacks. Only one away from Guppy. Master of lockpicking, I guess I'll take it. I mean, it's not really something that like I care too much about at this point. Because we've got like so many keys from all the sacks that we've gotten. I'll still take it. So a very successful boss rush acquisition there with lead pencil. It's going to fire off a monstrous lung shot every 15 shots. And as you see here, our fire rate being crazy, crazy high now, thanks to all the tiers upgrades we've gotten. We fire off those monstrous lung shots a lot. Now, I could have taken, if I wanted to remain defensive, I could have taken the cancer item instead, which would have given us the wafer effect every time we take damage inside of a room. And effectively, that doubles your late-game HP, but I wanted to go for offense here. The more offense, the better. We needed something that was going to up our damage by a lot. So now that we're not under the time crunch, we can go perusing a little bit, look for possibly a planetarium. We may have missed one on the last floor, obviously, because I didn't go look for it, because I was trying to rush to get boss rush. I do think that boss rush is still more important than planetariums. So I don't mind prioritizing that over looking for one. As soon as you go to the store, we need to utilize Keeper Sack. Hopefully we don't get a greed fight in here. Empty Vessel did proc again because we're now on no red hearts. Even though technically we still have the red heart container in the form of a bone heart. It doesn't count unless if it's filled. There's no planetarium, as I was kind of expecting. Actually, no, we can't get a greed fight because we fought Pride. That's right. Yeah, so there's no greed fight. Good. And hopefully there's a restock machine so we can use all these, all these 69 cents that we have. There wasn't. Booster pack. Get the bookworm transformation, ace of diamonds. Buying soul hearts left and right. I'm just doing this so I can buy another another full charge. Yeah. I mean, hey, it's a speed upgrade. It's not like a major upgrade, but still something good. And we got a moon card out of it. Fine with that. Fantastic. It's exactly what we needed. Sorry, I got something in my eye right now. I'm just a total mess these days. We did get taken to the Imera room with four more soul hearts. My goodness. I am error, more like I am winner. It doesn't really make sense, but I'm gonna pretend it does. I am error rooms, man, just absolutely crushing it. Happy to say I found this is gonna seem out of left field, but like work with me here. Oh, that's right, I'm not flying. So those of you who've been watching long enough to know. You may remember that, like, I was like, I'm not a big fan of Pizza Hut, right? But Pizza Hut had the best pepperoni rolls ever, and I will not hear arguments for anything else, right? I loved pepperoni or Pizza Hut's pepperoni rolls. They were incredible. Like they were oven baked with like they had like a mozzarella like. Or it was some kind of, I'm pretty sure it was mozzarella cheese roll inside of like, you know, the dough that was rolled. And then they had this incredible like garlic sauce that they put on with like butter and Parmesan cheese and stuff on like sprinkled on top. I mean, they were amazing. Dipped in ranch. It's like the most unhealthiest snack in the world. It's amazing. Well, unfortunately, Pizza Hut stopped serving them. My Pizza Hut anyway, and I, like, for the longest time, for like years and years and years, I was like, man, this sucks. I really just crave like a pepperoni roll, and I've tried pepperoni rolls from other places and they're like, eh, not that great. But I am happy to say that I found, thanks to DoorDash of all places, I found a local place here that actually does pepperoni rolls exactly like Pizza Hut did. And when I say exactly, I mean, like, I have a pretty discerning taste, right? Like, I'm very picky when it comes to certain things, especially when it's stuff that I like. But when I say exactly like it, I mean they're exact. They are so good. So thanks to DoorDash helping me out and making me kind of branch out. I'm like, because I particularly just stick to Domino's and, like, you know, I'm not even... To be honest, I'm not even a huge pizza guy anymore. But man, I was shocked and also like pleasantly surprised and also like a little worried now because like I'm trying to get slowly back into shape and everything and I'm like, this is gonna be bad because I'm gonna order like 5,000-6,000 of these at one time and just go ham on them and probably eat every single one. But man, they are solid. But it all goes back to that relational memory with food that I have. You know, when I eat, I've talked about this before, when I eat Rudy's, which is barbecue, Texas barbecue, I think, like, I have to watch Game of Thrones. Like, I just have to. That was my routine back when Game of Thrones was still on. I would go get Rudy's and then sit down and watch, like, an episode of Game of Thrones. Like, that's relatable. And we got Guppy in a random curse room of all things. And with the Pizza Hut pizza rolls, it was, for me, it was anime. It was normally I would be watching Naruto. So once I took the plunge and I was like, yeah, I'll try these pepperoni rolls. Why not? How horrible could they be? You know, and find out that, oh man, these are the exact same ones that Pizza Hut used to use. Like, I started firing up Naruto and I started watching, like, the older... Well, I mean, they're they're old now, but to me, they're still kind of new, the Shippuden episodes. And I was just instantly brought back to, like, sitting down, ordering an order of those, and just watching anime and stuff again. It was a nice feeling, nostalgic feeling. It's funny how food can do that. Got a Hwaz. Actually, completely wasted that. I forgot about the crawl space rule. Ended up taking Void. Void is going to use the undefined every time that we get a full charge, so it's kind of a waste because obviously, like, Void is just going to teleport us the second that we use it. But we might get some stats out of there. Now, we don't want to use Undefined here just because it has a chance to not take us down to where we need to go. But I will use Undefined in here. And that's the reason why. Well, we got a horse pill. We got to take the horse pill. And, man, these might be the best I Am Error rooms I have ever seen. Seriously. Pogatory, Sack Dagger. I'll go for Pogatory. Nancy Bombs. What a banger of a run here. Which feels good. It feels good to get an actual good run for once. Been having a string of just horrible runs on stream. Actually, we lost a run, that run that I was talking about earlier, actually, in this episode. On Saturday. It was before the Pokemon stream. We actually lost a run. And that run was horrible. We never got past 0.63 movement speed. And we just got whittled down. So to come back to it, gotta get back on my mojo here. There we go. We do get a tears up as well as a range up. And Undefined did take us closer to the boss, I think. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, we can definitely fit in a victory lap here. I think that's well and good in order. We had a speed run the other day too, so. And the Apollyon run yesterday was pretty darn good. Worthy of a speed run. Let's do it. Second seed, so 9-1 MC. Vengeful Spirit here. Again, remember, we don't want to use our we don't want to use Void yet until we're ready to get off the floor. Dice Bag. I think this is a situation where we don't necessarily want to be using Dice Bag here, because I don't want to reroll. I mean, we can take Dice Bag maybe, but I really don't want to reroll this. I'm pretty happy with where we are stats-wise. Dice Bag, you had a chance earlier this week, and you came through with one, and you didn't on the other. There's a little Haunt again. I will Void little Haunt, but first we ought to obviously want to go in here and grab some more stats, courtesy of, oh baby, courtesy of PH Dizzle. Found pills. All right, so now we can Void Lil Haunt, and let's see where this takes us. Got another tiers up to 8. I don't know why our tiers keep going up. Does Void have? Oh, thank you, Barrel. So yeah, that was a short-lived perfection there, but does Void allow you to break the tiers cap now? I guess we're going to take Dice Bag anyway and just head on Dizown. I don't know if Void allows you to do that or not. Torn Pocket. Got the Gaz rune, which I will save for a Curse of the Blind or something like that. Got the D-Sizzle one room too early. The Vico, no thank you. Like, Ludovic, no. Thank you. D10's gonna reroll enemies, not that we need to. And that red wisp that you see there, that was granted to us by Vengeful Spirit. We'll take Mom's Ring for a nice damage up and a Purthrow. There goes Ragman. We'll take Synth Oil for our second syringe. No, that's it. That's going to give us Spun. I totally forgot about Experimental Treatment. Oh, man. Well, I mean, we got to go Twisted Pair, even though this puts us down at half of a heart. We can use the Degas rune to get us a soul heart back. Which I'm just going to do right now just for safety purposes. And then we can void Ludovico. We got taken to the IMR or the Seeker Room. Now, we cannot take half of a heart of damage to get into the mob trap or boss trap room because we are on a victory lap. It would still accrue one full heart of damage. So got to be careful here with our HP, but again, I've got full faith that we'll be completely fine and protected from our damage. We just need to be, again, we just got to be super cautious when it comes to just barrels and stuff next to us with a finger. That's always the danger. Seraphim, I mean, I'll take Seraphim. Seraphim's good enough to have. Play the Judgment here for hopefully an HP upgrade. Be fine with just a regular HP upgrade. I mean, we have PhD, so I guess I could use it once. Bombs are key. And we've got plenty of keys and bombs. Lucky Sack, don't really need that. The D Fizzle, I'm not going to use it, but it's... Again, it's nice to know that we've got it here. I just don't think that we need to reroll this at all. We've got a pretty powerful run. Just because we're on low HP does not necessitate us rerolling everything that we've kind of built for this last 38 minutes and 47 seconds. Again, got the D6 one room too early. We're only on 1.5 soul hearts here, so again, we got to be careful. I don't know if that was a mini charge or a full charge up here. I think it was a mini charge. Yeah. So, if we planned it a little bit better, I could have gone to the curse room with a full heart. A full charge, I mean. Got Crack Crown. Crack Crown gives us a nice damage boost as well. Honestly, I'm not using the dice bag, so I'm fine with taking the Crack Crown here. But we've got to get some... We have to get some HP and hold on to it. We can't just keep pissing it away. With just bad damage here and there. Playing a little bit sloppy right now. I'd like to get some mapping as well, if possible. Everyone knows how much I absolutely love getting mapping. Core meiosis, your psiosis is going to be a nice little tier effect to add on top of here. Hey, we can consume the we consumed crack crown as well. Man, we do have a devil card, which is going to allow us to have a Bible effect, so we can instantly kill mom or mom's heart, depending on which one we want to use it for. Ice cube, sure. Okay, thank you, Nancy Bombs. Thank you. Appreciate it. Yeah, I would love I Have a Cult, but we just can't take it right now. Yeah, we can't take it safely anymore. Pageant Boy, I mean, I'd rather void these, to be honest. Got a shot speed out of it. At least this tells us that we can bomb our way into the curse room. Staying far away from any possible scatter bombs. You get an Eternal Heart, which I'm okay with. Right now, we need all the HP we can get. It's possible that we still could get back into the devil deal if we get another soul heart or something like that. We also get a dice room here. It's a global D6. We can reroll the wooden nickel in the shop. And then we can go check out what's in the curse room, and then we can use Undefined to get out of this curse room here, so we don't accrue any damage on our way out. Get a piggy bank again. All right. And we get taken to the I Am Air room, so... Or no I Am Air room, I mean, but back to the item room. Yeah, I would have loved to have gotten Eye of a Cult, but that's okay. All right, now we have a little bit of HP, a little bit of wiggle room. Tears up. We are absolutely capped on tears. I still don't know how we reached 8.65. There's a double soul heart payout. Obviously, boss rush is going to be easy for us here. I think that you could make an argument that we could even consider going to Old Hushy. It would be nice if we got a... get out of my way. Thank you. It would be nice if we end up getting restock or reroll machine, something like that, if we do go fight Old Hushy. I'll just, I'm actually going to pass on Tech X. I don't think that it gives us more DPS here. I think that what we've got now is sufficient. We lose a lot of tier effects when we go for Tech X as well. So we do get a treasure map, and we also get the 4.5 volt. I'll stick with the Alges rune for Old Hushy. We should be able to burn him down before Old Hushy actually like has a chance to do anything. Old Hushy. There we go. So I'm gonna go for. I mean, neither of these really help out, but I'm gonna go for a divorce pay. Well, we could also just void these because we don't need a tears up. I think voiding it's better. Our good friend Abyss. Get two black runes here. Oh, that would destroy our Alge's runes, so yeah. And again, the I Am Air rune's just killing it. But again, that is we can't get in there in the first place if it weren't for Undefined, so I think MVP definitely goes to Undefined here. For sure. Okay. Thinking over 11 luck now. We don't even have perfection anymore. We are just crushing everything now. Might be able to get into the boss trap room, which we are able to do. I mean, it's a regular HP upgrade. We can use it for fodder for devil deals. And because our luck is so high, look how much Mom's Eye is proccing. It's every shot. Yeah, now is the time when we want tough love. Ghost bombs, we'll take it. We might as well. Tears rate now sitting at 9.15. Yeah, Void absolutely is breaking our tears cap for us, which is something I did not know that it could do. I don't know how I didn't know that after all this time. The Soul of the Keeper. Yeah, so all we need is the Tinted Skull so we can skedaddle out of the Mom fight. Or out of the boss rush, I mean. Take the Polaroid, got our Devil Deal. Now we'll take some more Pogatory. We could take Sulfur as well if we really, really wanted to. I mean, with the 4.5 volt, it kind of makes sense. And I'll take Continuum as well. I just want to see what our damage is like. Pretty good. We can also continually use it over and over again because of the 4.5 volts. So yeah, we'll take it. I mean, we still could roll with Undefined for sure. But Undefined doesn't really do anything for us anymore because we no longer have any use for the tiers upgrades and stuff. You just saw right there. So we can leave Void behind and not have to worry about going to the Imera rooms, because I mean we can't skip stuff anymore because there's no guarantee that we're going to be able to get up to the cathedral where we want to go with it. And you know, it is nice that Void does give us the increased tiers upgrade cap, but at the same time, if you can stack Sulfur over and over and over again, get that Mega Brim, brother, sister, you got yourself a winning combo. So we say thank you to Undefined, thank you to Void, and shout out to all those I Am Era rooms, because man, they really made this run pop. We no longer need that Alge's rune, by the way. So I'm not worried about picking it up anymore. Because we are, especially with Sulfur here, like Old Hushy. This damage that we're going to have with Guppy, those flies, 20.51 damage at 9.15 tier delay. Yeah, Old Hushy is going to be old daddy. sure. Black bean. Okay, we got rid of the red hearts. Can't really see what's going on anymore. That's okay. Isaac's not really a game that you're meant to see things anymore. See things clearly anyway. Shove got hit so hard she wasn't even sure what was going on. We'll take old bandage, even though this does ruin Polaroid invincibility. Just in time for old Hushy. It's the large second scarred womb here. I think it's going to be to the top left. Man, Ice Cube is just going ham for us. Incorrect. I don't know what the hell that room was. Mom's Pearls gives us a soul heart and a range up and luck upgrade. Not that we really needed it, of course. And despite us having the treasure map, turns out, doesn't even matter. I thought that was Chubb. I thought that was Larry Jr. in the middle there. Kind of hard to tell at this point. More shots beat up. Two black soul hearts gonna help sweeten the deal for us. Speaking of deal, it's a Krampus Devil deal, which is gonna give us a huge upgrade with Lump of Coal. Man, we are about to do a lot of damage to old Hushy. We may not, like, honestly, we may not even use Sulfur here. Big Dog Tooth just for the damage upgrade. We get Birthright. Now, we can use Moving Box to take Birthright as well if we really wanted to. Oh, man. Immaculate Heart. That's a lot of damage. Mercurius is also a lot of fun, but I'm going to take Immaculate Heart just for the crazy amount of damage. I don't know if this is doing more damage with Sulfur than if we were just simply firing at Hush. Hard to tell. Hard to tell a lot of things, to be honest. I mean, we're doing good damage to him. There's no denying that. We did buku amounts of damage to old Hushy. Old Hushy. But see, our shot speed and our tears rate is so fast like this, it makes me wonder whether or not Sulfur is actually, like, even an upgrade at this point. Check out the secret room real quick, yeah. Okay. get the stapler, which is going to give us even more of a damage upgrade here. Yeah, see, that's that right there, that damage that we just did to Isaac makes me think that I think that we get better damage out of not using sulfur. Even though sulfur is cool looking and everything. Hey, long legs. We are going to get conjoined as well, which is just going to make things a lot more hectic. Hey, if it wasn't hectic, then it wouldn't be Isaac, baby. It's a very interesting pattern that we've got going on right now. Oh, man. And we get tough love, too. Get ready for the teeth. Yeah. It's just nothing but teeth shots at this point. I mean, 12.39 luck. Good lord. They're still alive over here. Speed up. Gulp that. Get purity as well. It's just going to boost our tears even more. Oh my goodness. Serpent's Kiss just to polish things off. And that is going to be that. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this crazy, crazy Eden run. If you did, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and get us closer towards that 210-day mark on the like streak goal for all items taken week. Thank you all very much for all the support on the channel. I really appreciate it. Hope you had a great start to your brand new week here in the Mosh Pit. And thank you again, everyone, for liking, commenting, and subscribing. As always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like The Revenant, Chocolate Milk Guy, Nicholas Fernald, Nathan Tollefson, and Austin Parente. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.